Hello. Today I was thinking of doing a bloom, but normally I always blow my petals with the hairdryer. You know, really that way, that way, that way. This time I want to try to point my hairdryer in the center and just swirl it like this around and see what happens. The colors that I'm going to use, where are they? That's the Artessa neon purple. Where did I leave all my colors? Let me see. The ginger flower from Colorarte. The jasmine from Colorarte. And I made my own, well, coral color, very pretty with the Colorarte Mango Freeze and a little bit of that fluorescent magenta from Golden in it. Really pretty. And I have the Sunburst, also a primary element from Colorarte. And I have made a light blue cell activator. And I just used that titanium white from Amsterdam, and I put in a couple of drops of that teal from Golden fluid. And now I have a light blue. So if you want to know my recipe, in the last 10 seconds of this video, you will see a little pop-up in the left upper corner. If you click on that, then you will go to the video with my recipe. And that's to make cell activator, all about the pillow paint, and all about how to mix your pouring medium for this technique. So first we are going to lay down the pillow paint. And it's pretty thick today. Maybe I should have tinted a little bit more, but well. Let's just see how it will go. I hope I can stretch it enough. Me just pop some air bubbles. Okay, we will start by putting the colors in the center. This is the Artessa neon purple, very pretty color, and that's from the ready to pour paint, the pouring acrylics from Artessa. I have a coupon code below. It's valid until January 26, I think. And if you would like to purchase some Colorarte pigments, I also have a coupon code below the video and in the comments. And that will be a 20% off for all items in the store. And let me see. Here is the Sunburst. Jasmine. Oh, so pretty. A little bit of that neon purple. And I will end with the ginger flower. Or not, no, I will end with the mango freeze and the magenta, fluorescent magenta from Golden mix. It's so pretty. Okay. Now in there, on top, we are going to put down the light blue cell activator. And this is sinking a little. That's probably because I put in the drops from that fluid Golden. But well, let's just see how this will go. So what I will do is I will go slowly down with my hairdryer, when I see that light blue paint spread, I'm just going to swirl this around and well, let's just see how that will look. Okay, now let's wait until the paint will settle a little bit. And then I can see if I want to blow it more out, or we are going to stretch it like this. I see some really pretty lacing. Yeah, I think I need to, I do need to spread it more to the sides. So that's what I'll try now. I hope I don't ruin it. It's looking very pretty. These colors are gorgeous together. I will show you a close-up. I hope you can see. Is that pretty or what? And I'm almost out of pillow paint, so I hope I have enough to tilt everything. And after this, I'm going to show you the dried up result of that flower of my last pour where we did not tilt. And while I'm saying this, it's actually still wet. So I have no idea at this moment how it dried, but I wait with publishing this video until that one is fully dry, and this one is then dry, of course, also. Okay, I hope I can stretch this one in a nice way, because I think it's gorgeous. Okay, let's go. Now let me put away my cups. I'm sorry, I'm a little bit messy today. Oh my goodness, this is so pretty, I'm afraid to tilt it. I need to remember this color combination, because this is awesome. Okay, back to the middle. I can see that the drops of the teal I put in my cell activator has thinned out my cell activator a little. because I can see that the lacing is not as strong as it normally is. So maybe next time I need to put that in a little bit more of that white from Amsterdam. But I'm waiting on my golden teal, the heavy body paint, but they didn't have it, so I need to wait until it's back in stock. But this is gorgeous. Oh my gosh. And it's taking a really long time now to stretch it all the way to that other side. I'm really, really happy with this color combination. Gorgeous. Okay, now look at the design. So we go a little bit back to the middle. Okay. Let me get my cups and put it down. Look at that. How pretty is this? Wow. I'm certainly going to do some more with these colors because this is out of this world. Okay guys, I will be back with a close-up, and after that I will show you the dried results of the other flower I did. Okay, here we are for the close-up. I hope I can show you how shimmery and beautiful it is. It's gorgeous, you guys. These colors go so well together. There you see that coral. That it looks a little bit like red now, but that's that coral with purple underneath. So that's what you see. It's so pretty. I hope it will dry like this. Oh my gosh. Yeah, well, it's always so hard to show you the real colors, but I hope you get it. Okay guys, after this I will show you the dried results, as I already said. Hello everybody. Okay, we are 3 days later now and the bloom has dried, and although I think it looks okay. I will show you a close-up. It did not really crack or anything. I don't think I like these ones as much as when we do normally the blooms. And that is because I think the pillow paint that I put on first, the white, was less thick than I normally would put on, and for that reason we could not blow that really beautiful petals that I have blown before with the ones I did stretch out. And so the petals look different. I think this looks more like a Dutch poor than it looks like a bloom poor. But well, now we know. And I will show you the white from up close. As you can see, there were a lot
of little air bubbles that popped. And that's because that pillow paint is pretty thick, so maybe I should have thinned it out a little bit more. But well, I just wanted to let you see that. But the bloom did not crack. And well, that's not too bad. And I did some more. I did this one also for practice. And this one also did not crack. Only the black, you know, from the cell activator. That does leave a kind of a structure because it's sinking in the other paint. But I guess it's pretty. But I don't know if I will do this again. And I think if I will do want to make this again, I will do it more like a Dutch pour and thin my paint out a little bit more. And I think this one actually did crack, you see? At one part, right here. But overall, it doesn't look too bad. And here I did another one. And I think this looks kind of messy. But well, this was all for testing. And this is a small part I actually do like about this, but I think this looks really messy. But this was all testing. And I'm happy that I did test all this, because you never know. And this is the pour we just did, that dried already also. And I'm sorry, what I wanted to show you was, look, the colors are beautiful. But that teal cell activator was a lot thinner than my cell activator normally is. And that's because I used that very fluid paint from Golden. So I guess I need to wait until my heavy body paint from Golden arrives to make a teal cell activator, because this was just a little bit too thin. And as you can see, it, well, it spread out a little bit. And on some parts, like here, it just sunk in the other paints. So my cells kind of disappeared. But all in all, I like it. And I really, really, really love those colors. So, I hope you enjoyed this video. And if you liked it, please give me a thumb up. Subscribe, and hopefully I see you in the next video. Bye bye.